Good afternoon, friends. Thank you so much for joining me here today, and I hope you're all having a wonderful and blessed Friday afternoon. President Joe Biden just officially signed a bill raising the United States debt limit. So now more spending bills can be passed to help the American people recover from this crisis. Friends, welcome back to my channel. This is your latest fourth stimulus check update and information. Also, in a video later today, I will be announcing the two winners of this week's Walmart gift card giveaway. It's not too late to enter my giveaway. All you have to do is make sure to watch until the end of this video to learn more details. President Biden signed into law a bill raising the nation's debt limit until December of this year, delaying the prospect of an unprecedented federal default that would cause economic disaster. The House passed a $480 billion increase in the country's borrowing ceiling on Tuesday, after the Senate approved it on a party-line vote last week. The eventual approval came after a protracted standoff with the Senate Republicans, who derailed initial Democratic efforts with filibusters, delays that require 60 votes to halt it. Ultimately, a handful of Senate Republicans agreed to join Democrats and voted to end GOP delays and move to a final vote on the legislation. But Minority Leader Mitch McConnell has said Republicans will offer no support for another increase in December. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen had warned that the United States would hit its borrowing limit, an unprecedented situation that she and others cautioned could lead to economic catastrophe for a nation still reeling from a global crisis.
Now look. My friends on the other side never had any problem providing $2 trillion in tax cuts for the very wealthy. Look, I don't think you shouldn't be able to make $1 million or $1 billion. I'm a capitalist, but guess what? I'm also listed for 36 years as the poorest man in the Congress. But I make big money now. I'm a president. But all kidding aside, I don't think we should punish anybody, but just pay your fair share. You know, the issue that has been championed by Rosa for years, in the past, if you paid your taxes and had an income high enough that you were able to take the $2,000 per child deduction, you could actually write it off your taxes. But how many families do you know of cops and firefighters and school teachers and what that don't have pay that much in tax because they pay tax? But there's nothing, you say you're going to get $4,000 back for your kids. Well, you know, it's not refundable. Either it comes off your tax bill or you don't get it at all. The American Rescue Plan, which these folks voted for as well, and I'm very proud of, is a real game changer. It started our economy moving again. Recognize that people with lower incomes don't get the benefit of that tax break because they don't have that much to deduct.
Routine government payments to Social Security beneficiaries, disabled veterans, and active duty military personnel would potentially be delayed, and the economic fallout in the United States could ripple through global markets. Republicans have said Democrats should use a budgetary maneuver to pass an increase in the debt limit without any Republican support, like the process Democrats are using for Biden's massive climate change and social safety net plan. But Democrats have resisted that option. The clash between the two parties leaves Congress without a clear solution to avert the next default deadline in December. But the White House has emphasized it is still pursuing a bipartisan increase. Lawmakers from both parties have used the debt ceiling votes as leverage for other priorities. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi threatened to vote against a raising debt ceiling when the former president was in office, stating that she had no intention of supporting lifting the debt ceiling to enable Republicans to give another tax break to the rich. And back in 2011, Republicans managed to coerce President Obama into accepting about $2 trillion in deficit cuts as a condition for increasing the debt limit, though lawmakers later rolled back some of those cuts. So friends, what are your thoughts on the debt limit increase? Please leave your thoughts in the comment section below. The key word for this video is cinnamon. If you would like to enter tonight's Walmart gift card giveaway, please make sure that you are subscribed to my channel, like this video, and comment below the keyword. Thank you so much, friends. As Congress wrangles over many proposals, within the Build Back Better reconciliation bill. One section holds the promise of addressing the anxiety of millions of American workers, retirees, and their families, and how they feel about their retirement security. To that point, Congress needs to focus on the retirement provisions, which are included in the budget reconciliation bill, that would both be impactful for both employers and their employees. One provision in the bill, passed by two House committees, would require businesses with five or more employees to offer a workplace retirement plan. Employers who already provide workplace retirement plans would not need to change their current offerings. As important, another provision would require employers to offer employees with $200,000 or more in a retirement account a choice to invest up to 50% of their balance in a protected lifetime income product. Providing this option would allow the employee to create a monthly income stream that they cannot outlive, mimicking the traditional pensions that many employers used to offer. Despite significant progress towards expanding retirement plan coverage for workers, more still needs to be done, requiring businesses that have not provided a retirement plan to now do so will increase small business employees' opportunities to save for retirement and lessen fears about whether they can afford to retire. Friends, do you agree with everything that is included in the new bill? Please leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you so much, friends, for joining me here this afternoon. I greatly appreciate all of you who are watching my videos. You can enter today's Walmart gift card giveaway by making sure that you like this video and comment below the keyword from this video. Thank you so much, everyone, and have a very blessed Friday.